in this area right in here is a little complex of very weak or very eroded markings. These were some of the first ones we found when we came to the mountain, and we had been told that some existed on this rock, so this is the ones that we were told of right here. They're almost gone. You have three in a row right here that are very difficult to see, but with the light in certain angle, you can see three circles here with radiating lines like sunbursts coming out from them. But where we'll be going in just a few minutes, there'll be a lot more visible and you'll be able to get some better photographs than what we're seeing right here.
And I used to eat my lunch right up here on the face of this rock, and when Tommy and I were up here looking for petroglyphs, I said, well, you know, we probably ought to go check it out because it's the kind of place where they ought to be. We estimate there's somewhere between 600 and 1,000 of these rock carvings on this particular rock face. And I guess all told on Pinnacle and Table Rock would be somewhere around 1,200 altogether, which is an incredible number of petroglyphs of the same motif in one site.
I don't know that we'll ever know exactly what these people were intended here, but we like to think that the location is the reason they're here. You can find rock everywhere, but they yet chose this particular spot to carve these rocks. And you can see why this would be a particular place. The view is just spectacular to the west. We have a feeling that it has something to do with, I don't say sun worship, but certainly maybe appreciation of the sun, the moon, and the view that you would get here of the sun and the moon would just be unparalleled in this part of the country. Who these people were, we don't really know. There's not much variety here. They were on a pattern of circular oriented carvings. Occasionally there will be a triangle or a square thrown in, and occasionally there will be sunburst thrown in with radiating lines. And the carvings here are more boldly done than those in the valley, and they're totally different than those in the valley. All of ours are basically invisible during the day, with exception of these on these rock domes here. So how do you find them? Well, we found them mostly on rainy days when the rain will reveal a slight scratching on the rock, or something will tell you that something was there. And then we go back at night with lights and take the light and just pan the surface of the rock, and it will bring these details out. And they're totally different from this, and you rarely find the circles there. So we have two things going on here. We have high domed petroglyphs, and we have petroglyphs that occur in the low valleys, and we found nothing in between.
Now, sometimes these oral traditions for Native American tribes will persist for hundreds of years because this is prehistory. There's no written record, so it's the only way they had of recording and documenting their past. So the fact that the Cherokees, who occupied this area of the Carolinas and Virginia for, experts tell me, close to 1,000 years, that they didn't even have an oral tradition of who made these petroglyphs tells me that they're very, very old, and that they predate the Cherokees.
Well, I kind of find that the fact that these are still a mystery is kind of a good thing, not a bad thing. It's good to know that you can go somewhere in the world today and find something you don't understand and that people did and left for us to ponder over. So I kind of like the mystery of it.
Well, this is without a doubt the largest rock shelter I've ever been in the mountains of South Carolina. It's about 100 feet across the front, 40 feet deep, and the ceiling is about 20 feet tall. So even though we haven't found any definite signs of occupation, it's the kind of rock shelter that a large group of people could stay in over a period of time.
There are two kinds of rock art: petroglyphs, which are carvings on rock, and pictographs, which are paintings or drawings on rock. We have found three pictographs, drawings, in shelters like this in the entire upstate of South Carolina. So sometimes you really can't see these with your naked eye. So we'll go into a shelter like this and we'll photograph the rock panels. Then we'll take that digital image and put it in a Photoshop program with a computer and separate the colors. If there's a drawing there that may be invisible to the naked eye, quite frequently you can pull it out and then recreate it, so to speak. We have one real good pictograph over in Churchill County that we found like this. And you can look at it with your naked eye and you won't see anything on the walls. So even though we don't see anything here today, we come in and we routinely photograph these anyway. And that's where we explore them. These hard, clean surfaces like this, you see here, something like that might hold a picture or a carving or some of these other clean walls behind you or even the ceiling. But where you have water running over it like this, it's pretty doubtful that it would last. So we would take a picture here, like so, and take that back and put it in Photoshop, play with the hue, the contrast, the saturation of paints, and start separating them and to see if anything would show up. And you can actually explore the entire cavern like that at your desktop. So that's the way we do it.
I started out about 15 years ago in doing an underwater hobby diver program that the South Carolina Institute for Archaeology and Anthropology supports. And so I started out doing underwater archaeology with the Institute and met Tom Charles through that. And then that evolved into a working relationship up here. I can't go on a trail now without seeing, you know, a big rock face and going out looking for carvings. And once your eye is accustomed to looking for them, you know, you can use light and shadow and get an idea of, you know, what's there, whereas before you would not have ever even seen it.
Well, this is one of the most interesting rock shelters, I think, in the mountains of South Carolina. If you look here on this back wall, there are 9 pictographs or cave drawings, pretty rare in South Carolina. There are only 3 known sites for pictographs in South Carolina. And interestingly, the same individual, Dr. Cato Holler, a dentist up in Old Fort, North Carolina, has discovered 2 of the 3, including this site. You can come to your own conclusion, as others have, but I think it represents a dog. Fortunately, at least 2 of the pictograph sites are on state parks and on publicly owned property, so they are permanently protected. And that's a good thing, because they would easily be vandalized, and at least these will be protected and available to the public and researchers for years to come.
I've found 6 sites that were reported to me that were destroyed before I could actually get out there to record them, and that's been in the very recent years, so they are going by the wayside. And we appreciate the public getting involved and sharing their information with us.